Panache is a Quarkus-specific library that handles most of the boilerplate code usually required by JPA-based persistence layers. One of the features it provides is ready-to-use and easily customizable repositories for your entity classes. Hi, I'm Torben Jansen. Welcome to the third part of my Quarkus Panache series. In this video, I will show you how to use Panache's repositories to build your persistence layer. If you are just getting started with Panache, I suggest you watch the first two videos first. You will find them here and in the video description below. And while you are at it, please subscribe and like this video if you learned something new. Repositories are a very popular pattern for Java-based persistence layers. They encapsulate the database operations you can perform on entity objects and aggregates. That helps to separate the business logic from the database operations and improves the reusability of your code. Martin Fowler defines the pattern as follows. It mediates between the domain and data mapping layers using a collection-like interface for accessing domain objects. Similar to Spring Data JPA support for this pattern, Panache's repository classes provide all the basic functionality, and you only need to add your custom queries. In this video, I will show you how to create repositories with Panache, how you can use them to execute standard operations, like persisting a new entity object, and how to define and execute your own queries. To get the most out of this video, you should have a general understanding of Panache. You also might want to watch my tutorial on Panache's support of the active record pattern before or after finishing this video. You will find the link to it in the description. Before you can create your repositories, you need to define your entity classes. Panache uses Hibernate, which implements the JPA specification. It doesn't introduce any additional requirements and can work with all entity mappings supported by Hibernate. Due to that, you can easily migrate an existing persistence layer to Panache and use all of your previous JPA and Hibernate experience. Here you can see a typical example of a JPA entity class. Hibernate maps the class to the chess game table and each attribute to a column with the same name. The ID attribute is the identifier, and Hibernate uses the database sequence games sequence to generate unique values when persisting a new entity object. The attributes player white and player black model managed many-to-one associations to the chess player entity. Your entity classes can also extend Panache's Panache entity and Panache base entity classes, but I don't recommend it. These two classes apply the active record pattern to your entity class, which I explained in the previous part of my Panache series, which you will find here and in the description. It's an interesting pattern that solves the same problem as the repository pattern. Both separate your database operations from your business logic, and Panache provides ready-to-use implementations of most standard operations. By extending the Panache entity or Panache base entity class, your entity class inherits one set of these methods. And Panache's repository provides a second set of these methods. So by applying both patterns, you end up with two sets of methods that do the same. Having one set of these methods is a great idea and makes implementing your persistence layer much easier. But you don't want to have two of them. It will only make your code base inconsistent and harder to maintain. As mentioned earlier, Panache's repositories provide you with a set of standard methods to find entities by their primary key. You can also persist, update, and remove an entity. The only thing you need to do to get this functionality is to define an entity-specific repository class. It has to implement the Panache repository or Panache repository base interface. The only difference between the two interfaces is that you can provide the type of your entity and its primary key attribute to the Panache repository base interface. The Panache repository defaults the primary key to type long. Both repository interfaces define multiple versions of persist, update, and delete methods, and multiple find by ID, find, find all, list, list all, stream, stream all, and count methods, which you can use to read data from the database. You can find a complete list of these methods in the Java doc of the Panache repository base interface. Panache provides the required implementations for all standard methods. Due to that, the chess game repository definition in the previous code snippet gets you a fully functional repository which you can inject and use in your business code. In addition to all the standard operations, you can add your own methods to implement custom queries. Panache's repository interface defines several find, find all, list, list all, stream all, and count methods that you can call with an additional query and ordering criteria. You can provide these criteria as a standard JPQL or HQA statement or using simplified HQL. You could, of course, use these methods in your business code, but I recommend encapsulating all database operations in your repository definition. This enables you to use methods with a higher abstraction level in your business code. Here you can see a typical example of such methods. In the next segment of this video, I will focus on using the simplified HQL option to define your query. I think it's the most interesting one, and you are probably already familiar with standard JPQL. If you watched my video on Panache's support of the active record pattern, most of the phrases will sound familiar to you. Panache supports the same feature set for both patterns. To adjust the ordering of your query results, you can call the find, find all, list, list all, stream, and stream all methods with an order by clause, for example, order by date desk. Panache's repository implementation extends this to from chess game order by date desk and executes this query. Let's create a query with a simple where clause that compares one entity attribute with a provided value. You do that by referencing a single entity attribute by its name and providing one bind parameter value, for example, date and local date now. When you call this method, Panache's repository implementation generates the query from chess game where date equals a bind parameter and sets local date now as the bind parameter value. If your use case requires a more complex where clause, you can provide it as the query string together with the necessary bind parameter values. I use that in the code snippet here. The method returns all games played on a specific date and in the defined round of a tournament. I use positional bind parameters in the previous statement. You can also use named bind parameters and provide a map with bind parameter values. For these simplified statements, Panache generates the queries from chess game where date equals bind parameter 1 and round equals bind parameter 2, and from chess game where date equals the bind parameter date and round equals the bind parameter round, and sets the bind parameter values. SQL doesn't support named bind parameters. Hibernate therefore generates and executes the same SQA statement for both HQA statements. The repository pattern is a very popular pattern used to implementing maintainable and reusable persistent layers. Each repository encapsulates the database operations performed on a single or a group of entities. Panache provides all of the code required to implement a repository with basic read and write operations. You only need to create a class that implements the Panache repository interface, and Panache provides this functionality for you. In addition to that, you can implement your own methods, which encapsulate all kinds of queries or more complex database operations. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free member library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like cheat sheets and ebooks about building efficient and scalable persistence layers with JPA and Hibernate. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!